Please subscribe our channel Education Point and press bell icon to get notification of new educational videos.
Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 346, and today I am going to discuss about gas liquid chromatography, commonly known as GLC. So in the case of gas liquid chromatography, the basic principle is the same, that it is based on adsorption. But here the instrumentation of gas liquid chromatography is little bit sophisticated, in the sense that here the mobile phase is inert gas. Inert gas means it may be helium, it may be argon, it may be nitrogen, which is put in a cylinder, for example. And then that gas is released. It will work as a mobile phase. And there will be column coil inside the box. And that column coil will be coated with some liquid, jelly type, adsorbent, and through which it will pass. And that is made up of metallic nowadays. Before, it used to be glass even, but nowadays it is usually that column that is called stationary phase. And here the impure mixture of the compound, especially terpene, it is widely used in phytochemistry. Those components which are volatile, or even if they are not volatile, at high temperature it has to pass so that it will be vaporized in the form of vapor. So that vapor will pass through that with that mobile phase, through that tube that is column, which is a spiral. It may be some 7 to 10 or up to 15 meter coil, and there they are separated, those mixtures, on the basis of their boiling point. Here the separation of those volatile mixtures, A, B, C, D, whatever are there, they are separated on the basis of their boiling point. The one which is having low boiling point will pass first, and it will be detected in detector. There is a detector, and in that detector the peak will appear. And then with that detector, there is recorder, or we can say nowadays sophisticated computer is attached. So with that computer, the graph will be there. So first graph, first peak, what we will get will be those components which are having low boiling point. Then followed by the second one, which is having higher boiling point, and like that. So in that case, the highest boiling point will be the last one. In the same way, like in TLC plate, the movement is going as the one which is lighter molecular weight will be moving faster. And here, if suppose the two components, they are having same boiling point, then the component which is having lighter molecular mass and the one which is having heavy molecular mass or complex molecular mass will be moving slowly. So in this way they are detected. Nowadays with this, again to make it more authentic of this purification, with this computer it is attached, that is mass spectroscopy, mass spectra, to check the fragmentation. In the smallest fragmentation, by bombarding with high speed electron, which will knock down one of the electrons, and it will get we will get molecular with positive ion, and that positive ion with different fragments, it will be clear that what type of component it is. It is just like, I can say, if suppose lot of fragments are there for a chicken or for anything, you are given small pieces. Once you reconstruct all those small pieces slowly, then you will know whether it, after the small fragmentation, those fragments, when they are attached one by one, then you will know whether it is a chicken or it is a pigeon or it is other type of thing. In the same way, those reconstruction is done with the help of mass spectra, which is attached to gas chromatography. And it is called gas liquid chromatography because liquid phase is your stationary phase. Sometimes if stationary phase is solid, then we call it gas solid chromatography, like that. And nowadays this has become a powerful tool where we call it GCMS. GCMS means a gas chromatography combined with mass spectra to get fragmentation. With that, it will be very clear. And it, the graph what we get, this only retention time is given there, how much time the each one component is taking, and with that the peak is appearing. Whether it is retention time is 1 minute, 2 minute, 10 seconds, 50 seconds, like this. So all these are the detail of gas liquid chromatography. And here, of course, the best thing, if once students are going to any instrumentation center where if they can see by themselves, then they will understand very well. And basically, the GLC, that is gas liquid chromatography, is divided into four portions. The one is known as, that is the column. The second one is heater, where it is heated. And the third one is gas, and then detector. So all these I am giving you one by one. As we know that apparatus required for gas liquid chromatography is sophisticated and expensive as compared to thin layer column chromatography. The apparatus of gas liquid chromatography has four components. Number one, the first component, that is called the column. And I have already told you the column, that is a spiral one. I will try to sketch one diagram, I will show you. It is a long narrow tube. It can be 3 meter to 1 meter long. And even it can go up to more than that to spread the length. A made up of metal in the form of coil to conserve space. That's where coiling is done. It is packed with a stationary phase, that is 15% silicone oil. This silicone oil is a form of gel. This will act as stationary phase. And this is a liquid form or semi-solid form on an inert powder that is known as chromosol or cellite, etc. The packing is not essential, and alternatively an open silica gel column is used in which the stationary phase is spread as a film on the inside surface of capillary GLC. So actually inside the wall of the capillary tube, they are spread as a thin coating of that gel. Number two, the heater. This heater, what I have already told you, it will provide very hot temperature, so that even if the component is in liquid form, it will change into vapor form, because whatever component we are taking, the mixture of substance, it must be in vapor form. Once it is liquid, this heater will change into vapor form. It is provided to heat the column slowly from 50 degree centigrade temperature to, even it can go up to 350 degree centigrade temperature at a standard rate, and to hold the temperature of the column. Inlet is separately controlled so that the sample can be rapidly vaporized as it is passed on the column. The sample dissolved in hexane or ether is injected by the hypodermic syringe into inlet through a rubber spectrum. Number three, the gas flow. It consists of an inert carrier gas such as argon, helium or nitrogen. The separation of the compounds on the column depends on the passing this gas through controlled rate. Now the fourth one, which is very important one, that is known as detection device. Nowadays, detection device is very much sophisticated and computerized. And here with this detection device, we are attaching the mass spectra, means high speed electron will be bombarding, so that whatever purified substances has come, still we are not very much sure that they are 100% pure. So just to guarantee the purity, again it is fragmented there. So the electron will be knocked down by hitting up that accelerated electron, and we will get M positive here. The molecules in their positive ion, and that fragmentation is small, will be reconstructed and you will get the exact structure. So here number four is detection device. It is needed to measure the compounds as they are swept through the column. Detection is frequently based on either flame ionization or electron capture. The former method requires hydrogen gas to be added to the gas mixture and to be burnt off in the actual detector. The detection device is linked to a photometric recorder, which produces the results of the separation as a series of peaks. Just here, it will give the separation as a series of peaks. Produces the results of the separation as a series of peaks of varying intensity. Different intensity is there. So this is, I have just tried to give the sketch, you know, diagram to give you the idea, the picture, so that if you are visiting the instrument, it will be clear to you. The first place where there must be gas in gas cylinder, and that is your helium inert gas. That inert gas will be passing to this column, which is a spiral column, and this column inside is this position which is coated. It is stationary phase and this is your mobile phase. And in this, when it is passing through it, that is in vapor form, so you know it is going to allow the molecules on the basis of their boiling point. So the one which is having lowest boiling point will go first. So first lowest boiling point will be recorded here on the detector, the peak, and then followed by, so this is our, I mean the lowest one will be first here within 20 minutes or 20 seconds, then the second one within 30, and the one which is highest boiling point will be the last one, which will be recorded, which may need even 70 minutes or even 70 seconds, something like that. So here it is inside how it is happening, and on the basis of that, and this is your stationary phase, this is your mobile phase, and here nowadays we are putting in between the computer and detector mass spectra. In this mass spectra here, the accelerator electrons will knock down the molecules electron, and it will be converted into positive ion, molecular ion, and that molecular ion will be fragmented, and with that fragmentation, when we join one by one, then after joining that, and once you see the peak, and you will be having the value in your previous record, so by comparing, you can establish the structure. So how this device, that is known as gas liquid chromatography, is used for purification, identification of the compounds, and even to establish the structure of the compound by combining mass spectra, and that's why together it is known as GCMS. So with this I will stop here. Thank you very much for watching, and now in the next lecture I am going to discuss about high performance liquid chromatography that is known as SPLC. Thank you very much for watching.